Minister for Defence, National Security and Policing, Rural and Maritime Development and Disaster Management. Honourable Minister Ines Ruiratu, you have the floor, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Sir, let me, from the very outset, say that no doubt, there is no element of doubt whatsoever that evacuation centres are important for the good and for the safety of our people. And of course, government does agree, and let me also assure that this Honourable House, that government is also committed to the construction and retrofitting of evacuation centres, Mr. Speaker, sir. Mr. Speaker, the Honourable Member talked about our fear and feeling insecure whenever we have disasters. But I must also ask the question of what are we doing about our responsibilities as well. Because if we are in this state of fear, if we are insecure, of course, the question that we also need to ask is, how will we eliminate, how will we get rid of this feeling of fear and insecurity? It comes with responsibility, Mr. Speaker, sir, and we have often said in this August House that development is partnership. There must be partnership between government and the people and the communities. That's something that we need to take seriously, Mr. Speaker, sir. We appreciate the work done by previous governments, Alliance government, SVT, SDL. But it is not correct to state in this House that this government no longer constructs evacuation centres. Let me go back to 2015, Mr. Speaker, sir. Mr. Speaker, in 2015, government completed retrofitting 3 evacuation centres, Nadokoni in Burmasanga, Wasabulu in Lambasa, Navakaka village in Nabatu. In 2017, Mr. Speaker, sir, government completed retrofitting works for the following ECs in Sambeto, in Ba, Narokorokoyao village at a cost of $40,000, Kroya the village at a cost of $40,000, Namboti the village at a cost of $20,000, Mr. Speaker, sir. In 2018, Mr. Speaker, sir, government built 4 evacuation centers in the Konrobe, Nawakawa village in Tabeuni at a cost of $65,000, at Tabuki village at a cost of $100,000, at Nukumbol village at a cost of $47,000, at Tambia village at a cost of $75,000, Mr. Speaker, sir. In 2019, there were already evacuation centers to be constructed, Mr. Speaker, sir, and that includes Matadula and Maumi in Teilebu, Saliandrau in Namosi, and of course Narikoso and Rogobuaga in Ba, but we all understand the situation that we are in, and the communities have been advised accordingly. But Mr. Speaker, sir, to say that this government is no longer making available this facility to assist our rural communities is an outright lie. That is not correct, Mr. Speaker, sir. Let me say, Mr. Speaker, sir, let me say that the concept of evacuation centres is a proactive measure put in place by government to ensure that Fijians in affected communities are protected and provided with basic human needs such as water, food and accommodation during disasters. It is important to note that due to climate change, larger and more damaging disasters are the new norm, and we need to be prepared year-round rather than just in the predicted cyclone season. Mr. Speaker, sir, the will of the people is reflected in the government, and this is why they choose this government, Mr. Speaker, sir. And those will of government and the will of the people are reflected in the policies of government. Mr. Speaker, sir, this is the disaster risk reduction policy of government for the years 2018 to 2030, Mr. Speaker, sir. It talks about preparedness. We need to prepare now to minimize the damages and, of course, the loss of unnecessary lives as well when there is disaster. It talks about key structural measures, Mr. Speaker, sir. And I'll refer on a few. Safer schools, safer hospitals, villages are just waiting for the next Bosibakoro or for all the that we do, Mr. Speaker. However, Mr. Speaker, sir, we need to fully utilize that. Instead of properly building another kindergarten, it can be better used. That is why it needs to be a multi-purpose center. And of course, we have started building purpose-built evacuation centers as well, Mr. Speaker, sir. Let me go to the schools. We understand the economic disparity in our communities. That is a fact, Mr. Speaker, sir. I've talked about responsibility, but of course, in the absence of these facilities in the communities, there are alternatives. But people need to move quickly, and this morning, this week, I have been talking to the media. They've been asking me, oh, why didn't the siren come up? There is a difference between alert and warning. When the alerts are given, that is the time for you to start moving. Don't leave it too late, Mr. Speaker, sir. And this is why the unfortunate case in Tabeuni, I've personally made the effort to go to that mandir in Tabeuni and apologized to the mandir committee, Mr. Speaker, sir. But this is the fact about that situation. That was not a government-designated evacuation center, but the advisory councillor who was worried about the safety of the people who did not adhere to the alert that was given earlier, left it too late when the wind was at its peak, then they wanted to start moving. And unfortunately, Mr. Mahendra Chaudhary did not state this fact. The next evacuation center is 6 kilometers down. If you have been to Tabeuni, he was referring to South Tabeuni Secondary School. 6 kilometers down the road to get to that place. So it was on the initiative of the advisory councillor that she asked the Mandir committee and the priest if these people can be sheltered there. But of course, people need to take responsibility and respect the place. Government doesn't have to be blamed because it was not a designated evacuation center by government, but what on the initiative, in the interest of safety, that I have already stated, that the advisory councillor asked if they could be sheltered there. I have apologized on behalf of government, Mr. Speaker, sir, and I've assured the chairman of the Mandir, you have every right to close this facility. But if people come here, they have to respect this place. On schools, Mr. Speaker, sir, we have government already has about 1,033 registered evacuation centers throughout Fiji. And the majority of these are schools, 443 in the Central Division, 86 in the Eastern Division, 198 in the Northern Division, 306 in the Western Division. We have come up lately with a new app on that you need to use in order to find out where your nearest evacuation center is. And Mr. Speaker, sir, let me also say that through the Build Back Better program of government, after T.C. Winston, we reconstructed or retrofitted resilient infrastructure with a total of 118, Mr. Speaker, sir. 33 of these were schools. And most of these schools, I would proudly say here, Mr. Speaker, sir, withstood Category 5 TC Yasa in the recent calamity that we went through, Mr. Speaker, sir. But let me share some ideas to the honorable members of the House. Maybe we can go back now to our communities. Government has a long list of priorities that cannot be addressed all at once. I've spoken go to the Ministry of Agriculture, or go to the Ministry of Rural Development through the self-help project or through the programs in here, $100,000 suckers at $1. That's one evacuation center cashed within a period of 9 months, Mr. Speaker, sir. Sawayak and Ngau has done that. They did not have to run back to government and ask for money because through their Yangona planting program, they have managed to construct the new evacuation center. Nosolo in Bua, they don't have to come back to government to ask for money. There are ways. We just need to organize and let's get these ideas across to the people to make sure that retrofitting, Mr. Speaker, sir, that is continuing. But let me assure this August House, government values and government takes seriously the safety and the well-being of our people, and we will continue. When we have the resources, Mr. Speaker, sir, we will continue with the building of evacuation centers and retrofitting according to this document, purpose-built evacuation centers and multi-purpose centers, so that our people can be safe. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir.
I thank the Honourable Minister for Defence, National Security, for his reply. Honourable Members, at this juncture, I have been asked